began investigating Harvey Weinstein, which felt like climbing Mount Everest. We just basically started with the question of, has Harvey Weinstein mistreated women over the years, and what could we find out about it? We really wish that we could bring everyone here tonight on our entire reporting journey and introduce you to the people we met and share those moments of dawning recognition with us. We've actually decided to write a book about this in an attempt to kind of bring you to through the journey with us. Thank you. But since we only have a few minutes tonight, what we just wanted to do is really thank the extraordinary people we worked with on this story. A round of applause for the women who came forward, please. These were famous women. These were non-famous women. These were actresses. These were former employees. These were other former employees who helped us. It was scary for everybody. They held hands together. They jumped. We are forever grateful to them. We are really grateful to the New York Times. We had the privilege of watching a great institution rise to its highest heights and confront a bully. And that was an amazing thing to watch as a reporter.
And in the course of our reporting, what became clear was that it wasn't just a single predator. There had been predators who had been allowed to operate unchecked in a variety of industries. And what's been so remarkable in the last several months, you know, 2017 really landed with a bang. I mean, this was the first time that women were able to step forward and come forward with their allegations without fear of being shamed, of being abused in the public spotlight. And so, but it wasn't just the predators who came into focus. It was also the systemic failures that have allowed them to operate unchecked across all these industries, from HR departments that failed to protect employees, to lawyers who swooped in to help silence women who did step forward with allegations. And so I think rounding the corner into this new year, it's gonna be incumbent on all of us to think, now that these systemic failures have been exposed, what are some of the systemic solutions that can come into focus here in the new year and make sure that all women are protected in all workplaces across this country? And so, and we're going to be sticking with this issue, you can be sure, and we'd ask that you stick with us. So thank you guys again.